Hi guys, welcome to my channel Neet's Travel and Food. Hope you all enjoying watching my recipes video. If you like it, please give a like, comment and share. Don't forget to subscribe if not done yet. And please click on the bell icon for new uploads.
Hello friends, this is Rajesh from Neet's Travel and Food. And today I'll share with you my 3 days trip to Rameshwaram. Rameshwaram is well connected to various parts of the country by road. Regular bus services are regulated by the local transport across various other cities and places. The Rameshwaram railway station is directly connected via rail to all major stations of Coimbatore, Trichy, Madurai, Thanjavur and Chennai. The nearest airport to Rameshwaram is Madurai Airport, which is around 149 km from the city. Tuticorin Airport is also located at a distance of 142 km that happens to be medium of reaching Rameshwaram by air. Buses, cabs and rented taxis can be taken from outside of the airport to reach the city and furthermore. After freshening up at the hotel, we started our day trip from Abdul Kalam Memorial, which was at a short distance from our hotel. APJ Abdul Kalam Memorial was built by DRDO around his burial place to pay tribute to India's own missile man. This memorial displays an impressive collection of Dr. Kalam's, including replicas of missiles and rockets. After spending an informative time at the memorial, we next tuned up our next destination, Vilundi Theertham. The story behind Vilundi Theertham is quite historical. You will find a temple and a well near to the sea. This well was made by Lord Rama by dipping his bow in the sea water to quench the thirst of Ma Sita. You will find a man around the well with a bucket and a rope to serve the people with the water from the well. After Vilundi Theertham, we headed next to Armin Beach, which is also known as Khushi Beach. This was a 30-minute drive from Vilundi Theertham. This beach is around 2 km long and perfect place for relaxing and spending moments amid scenic beauty. This place is not having any sets, so don't forget to carry your hat and sunscreen with you. Ended our day trip with Annai Indira Gandhi Road Bridge, or also called Pamban Bridge. The byline road next to the bridge will give you a clear view of this railway bridge. This railway bridge connects Mandurampam town with Pamban Island and Rameshwaram. This bridge was opened in 1914 and was India's first sea bridge and also the longest sea bridge until the opening of Bandra's World League Sea Link in 2010. This bridge has a double leaf bascule section midway, which allows two ships or barges to pass through at the same time. Our second day tour started with visit to Sri Ramnath Swami Temple, which is dedicated to Lord Shiva. This temple is famous for a collection of lingas made up of sand, salt, stone and also other elements. This temple is also the second largest pillared corridor in the world. According to stories, there were around 112 ponds, out of which only 12 were left. Before coming to the temple, devotees take a bath at Agni Theertham to get rid of their sins. We next headed to the five-paced Hanuman temple, located just 2 km from Rameshwaram temple. This temple is famous for the five-paced Lord Hanuman idol, carved out of a large Senthuram stone. This temple also housed stones used to build Ram Setu, which was built by Lord Hanuman's monkey's army to rescue goddess Sita from Lanka. Gandhamandana Parvatam. This temple is dedicated to Lord Sri Rama, and you can find his feet imprinted on the chakra placed in the temple. This temple is also popular for sunrise and sunset viewpoint. You can also view Doordarshan Tower from the temple. Our next destination was the house of India's own missile man, in which he lived and was located in Moscow Street. This house was later converted into a museum to showcase photographs, certificates, doctorates and awards right from his childhood days. Abdul Kalam House is a two-story building with ground floor containing shop of handmade souvenir and seashells as specialty here. The upper floors are having art gallery and museum. Dhanushkodi is a town which lies on the southern part of Rameshwaram, where Ram Setu was built by Hanuman and Lord Rama's army with limestone to reach Lanka. The road to Dhanushkodi viewpoint is scenic and breathtaking, with Bay of Bengal on one side and Indian Ocean on the other. From Dhanushkodi viewpoint, you can view a thin stretch of sandy path disappearing in the water after some distance. And this is only remains of the Adam Setu or Ram Setu as of now. This place gets closed for tourists in the evening. Dhanushkodi once was a busy port town with railway station, temples, church, post office and also jetty services to transport travellers to Talaimannan in Sri Lanka until the unfortunate night of 22nd December 1964. When a super cyclone hit Dhanushkodi. The scenic beauty of Dhanushkodi inspired me to write a shayari on the spot to capture the view in words. Yo to kai baar lehre patharon se takra ke laut jati hai. यूं तो कई बार लहरें पत्थरों से टकरा के लौट जाती हैं पर फिर कुछ और लहरें समेटे किनारा चूम जाती हैं। जिंदगी भी हमें मुश्किलों से बांधे एक कदम पीछे ले जाती है पर तू लहरें बन आगे बढ़ मुसाफिर मंजिल खुद तेरे पैरों तले चली आती है। Kothandarma Swami Temple or Vibhishan Tirtham is a shrine located 12 km from Rameshwaram near to Dhanushkodi. This temple is believed to be more than 1000 years old and withstood 1964 cyclone which had ruined the entire town of Dhanushkodi. If you are fond of marine species, then this next destination should be a part of your trip list. Mandapam CMFRI, Central Marine Fisheries Research Institute, which was built in 1947 as headquarter to CMFRI, and in later in 1971 the headquarter was transferred to Cochin. This museum has a separate building that contains a large variety of preserved marine specimens. Turtles and large sea animals are kept separately in large cement tanks. At the Mandapam Institute, we got the chance to touch starfish, sea cucumbers and sea urchin. houses many fishes kept in large glass tanks filled with running seawater taken from the nearby sea by using motorized water pumping system. Hope guys you enjoyed watching the video, so please let us know your views in the comment section. And don't forget to subscribe and click on the bell icon for upcoming new videos.